Hi guys, back with me again, Adi Kurniawan Yusuf. So in this video, we're gonna talk about working capital management. So working capital management, basically how to manage our working capital as our short-term investment. Now let's learn deeper. What is actually working capital management? Working capital management is the process of managing current assets and current liabilities to ensure short-term liquidity of your firm. So one more time, working capital management is the process of managing current assets and current liabilities to ensure short-term liquidity of your firm. Why current assets and also current liabilities? Because in net working capital formula, we know that net working capital equals to current asset minus current liabilities. Because we talk about working capital management, so we have to be able to manage the current asset and also current liabilities. So what will be discussed in working capital management? We're gonna discuss about current asset and also current liabilities. Specifically, we're gonna talk about cash, account receivable, and also inventory as the current assets, and also account payable as the current liabilities. But in this video, we only cover account receivable, inventory, and also account payable. Well, for cash, we're gonna talk deeper in the next video. First is account receivable. What is account receivable? So basically, account receivable is funds due from a customer. So our customer purchase goods from us, but they pay in credit. Because of that, we have account receivable. As the seller, usually we give credit term. The example of the form of credit term is like this: 210 and 30. What does this mean? It means if the customer pays in 10 days, they will get 2% discount. But the maximum payment is in 30 days. One more time, if the customer pays in 10 days, they will get 2% discount, while the maximum payment is in 30 days. So they have to pay no more than 30 days. Now if the credit term is like this, 310 and 40, what does it mean? It means if the customer pays in 10 days, they will get 3% discount, while the maximum payment is in 40 days. Is it clear, right? For account receivable, what is actually the company's target? So the company's goal in account receivable is that how that companies could get its account receivable as soon as possible. If the customer pay it sooner, it will be better for the company. There are several credit policy that is usually implemented by the company. The company has credit term that consists of credit period and also discount, like what you have learned before. And also, usually the company has credit standard, it to measure the customer risk. And also the last one, the company has collection policy, how to collect the receivable from the customer. It is also related to the toughness used in the process of collecting the receivable. The length between the customer makes credit until they pay is called as receivable period or average collection period or day sales outstanding. How to measure receivable period or day sales outstanding? In the previous video about financial statement analysis, you have learned several ratio. Receivable period or DSO equals to 365 divided by receivable turnover. Receivable turnover is annual sales divided by receivable. It means receivable period or DSO equals to 365 divided by annual sales divided by receivable. We can modify the formula so DSO equals to receivable divided by annual sales divided by 365. Annual sales divided by 365, we can call this as daily sales. Because of that, receivable period or DSO equals to receivable divided by daily sales. So these are several formula to calculate receivable period or DSO. This is the sample question. McDowell Industry sells on term of 310 net 30. Total sales for the year are $912,500. 40% of the customer pay on the 10th day and take discount, while the other 60% don't take the discount. Question A, what is the day sales outstanding? This is DSO or receivable period. B, what is the average amount of receivable? We can see in the question, there is credit policy or the credit term 310 and 30. And also we know annual sales 912,500. 40% of the customer takes discount, they pay in day 10. And 60% don't take the discount. It means they pay in due date. It is in day 30 because in the credit policy and 30. It means the due date after 30 days. So we calculate DSO. What is DSO? DSO is the average length customer pays its receivable. 40% customer pays in 10 days, while 60% customer on time, it means pays in day 30. So we can simply calculate the DSO like this. 40% times 10 days, because 40% of the customer pay in 10 days, plus 60% times 30, because 60% of the customer pay in day 30. It equals to 22 days. Question B, calculating the receivable. We know the formula receivable period or DSO equals to receivable divided by annual sales divided by 365. So 22 as the receivable period equals to receivable divided by 912,500 divided by 365. So we can find that the receivable equals to 22 times 912,500 divided by 365. So we can find the receivable is $55,000. For account receivable, is it easy, right? Now let's go to inventory. Inventory management is related with supplies, raw material, work in process, and also finished goods. So what becomes the company's target in inventory management? So company can order in the optimal cost, and of course company expect to increase the inventory turnover. So by the time they purchase inventory, they can sell it again quickly. How to calculate optimal cost and also quantity in ordering the goods will be related to economic order quantity concept that we may discuss next time. Now, this is the formula to calculate inventory period. Inventory period equals to 365 divided by inventory turnover. As we know, inventory turnover equals to annual cost of goods sold divided by inventory. So, inventory period equals to 365 divided by the inventory turnover. It is annual cost of goods sold divided by inventory. So, how to calculate inventory? Simply, we can modify the formula. Inventory equals to inventory period times COGS divided by 365. Sample question. Soko Corporation has annual cost of goods sold $730,000. If the inventory conversion period is 10 days, how much is the inventory in the balance sheet account? As we know, the annual COGS is $730,000 and the inventory period is 10 days. How to calculate inventory? Directly put this formula. Inventory equals to inventory period times COGS divided by 365. So inventory equals to the inventory period 10 days times the annual COGS 730,000 divided by 365. It equals to $20,000. Inventory finished. Now let's talk about account payable. Account payable or trade credit is debt due to credit sales made by the company. What becomes company's target? Of course, the company want to have flexibility in paying the supplier, but the company has to keep the account payable account not too high. Because it is account payable, it also will be related to the credit term. If the company purchase goods from the supplier $1,000 every day, and they get credit term 210 and 30. It means company can pay in 30 days, right? Because every day the company needs $1,000. So if they pay in 30 days, the account payable balance will be 1,000 times 30. It equals to $30,000. Because every day company makes 1,000 credit and then they just pay it after 30 days. So in 30 days, the account payable balance will be $30,000. Based on the credit term 210 and 30, actually the company can pay in 10 days and get 2% discount. So company actually has two options here. First is that pay in 10 days and get 2% discount. Or second, company can pay longer without discount. In the second option, the company pay longer without discount. It means the company has to pay more than the first option because they don't get any discount, right? The additional payment because the company don't take discount, we call this as cost of trade credit. One more time, the additional payment because the company don't take discount, we call this as cost of trade credit. While for the first option, because they take discount, it means there is no cost of trade credit, or I can say free trade credit. How to calculate cost of trade credit? This is the formula how to calculate nominal annual cost of trade credit. The discount, it is 2%, and then 100 minus the discount times 365 divided by days credit is outstanding is the maximum length we can pay the credit, which is 30 minus discount period is the maximum day we get the discount, it is 10 days. So here we can calculate nominal annual cost of trade credit. What is the implication for our real life? So if the bank offers you credit with annual rate less than cost of trade credit, it means you can borrow from the bank and take the discount, right? Because cost of borrowing in the bank is less than cost of the trade credit. But remember, what we have calculated is nominal interest rate. We have learned in this video, nominal interest rate is not the same with effective annual rate. That's why we have to calculate effective annual rate to make it more precise because we consider the compounding effect. EAR equals to 1 plus I to the power of M minus 1. I here is the interest per period. So the I is equals to percentage of discount divided by 100% minus percentage of discount. While for M is number of period in 1 year. So 365 divided by days credit is outstanding minus discount period, it is the M. Let's go to directly the sample question. Term of credit given by the supplier is 210 and 40. How much is the nominal annual cost of trade? So we just directly input to the formula. The discount is 2% divided by 100 minus the percentage of discount, 100 minus 2% times 365 divided by days credit is outstanding. It is 40 days because N40 minus discount period, we get discount maximum in 10 days. So it is 10. So 0.0204 times 12.1667. It equals to 24.82%. Now, if I ask you what is the effective rate, we can know from our previous calculation, the I is 0.0204, right? The M is 12.1667. That's why we can calculate EAR using the formula 1 plus I to the power of M minus 1. Just input the I and also input the M, we can find the EAR equals to 27.85%. Yes, EAR mostly larger than the nominal interest rate. And this is the real interest rate that you have to spend. Then how if the bank offers you credit with EAR 30% per annum? You can see here the effective cost of trade credit is 27.85, while the bank can give you money with interest rate 30%. It is larger than the cost of trade credit, so it is better for you not borrow from the bank. It means no need to take the discount, just pay in 40 days. How to calculate payable period? Payable period is average time the company pays its supplier or pay its loan. The formula is simple. Payable period equals to account payable divided by annual COGS divided by 365. This is the sample question. Account payable is $4,000. Annual COGS is $36,500. What is the payable period? So payable period equals to account payable divided by annual COGS divided by 365. Just input the formula, account payable $4,000, annual COGS $36,500 divided by 365. We can find the payable period is 40 days. It is easy, right? So you have learned about account receivable, second is inventory, and the third one is account payable. In the next video, we're gonna learn about cash. While inventory period, receivable period, and also payable period will be used to calculate the amount of working capital needed by the company. That's why you have to learn this video well first before go to the next video.